Alright, so you know how the switch works, you know how it's connected to the battery. Notice how far that iron is. I couldn't tell you exactly where that iron is, but it's about probably midpoint, because my big wheel can do this number, and that iron is enough to attract these magnets there. So if I put it down any lower, I start getting the magnets doing this to the plexiglass there, and I get more scratch marks in there. But all those plates are going this way. If I put that sand in there, it's going to line up that way too. But that's what I was saying, is with them in this orientation, it needs to be this shape. This shape won't work as good as that shape, just because the flux is wanting, I don't understand it sometimes. I just know it's that flux going through here that is pushing, as far as I can tell. I mean, if I understood all this, I wouldn't keep playing with it. I just build it. But I know that coil right there will kick back a lot more than this coil sitting right there, or right there. Right there would be ideal, but I can lay them like that so my metal plates are all following that magnetic field line. And you can tell by the dimly lit bulbs that it's not using as much power. At first it does. You can always tell at first because those lights will be bright. Funny how I'm like pointing at the screen instead of pointing at the light. So I don't know how you would do it exactly, because you'd need like a big U-shape to make the two gaps of those two magnets. The other one I was thinking was like that shape. So you could have one kind of pulling in and the other one pushing out from the top and bottom. Just have those, like, the two legs, like that. I don't know. Tell me what you think.